will be making YouTube thumbnails in Creative Cloud Express, and I'll also be sharing a few tips for making your thumbnails stand out on YouTube. The first thing we're going to do with this template, we're just going to click on the photo, we're going to hit replace, and then today I'm going to pull from my Lightroom. I always use my Lightroom libraries when making these projects. It's just such a good way to like save so much space on your computer. I used to just download everything from Lightroom and then re-upload them. Now I could just skip that middle step and then just pull directly from my Lightroom. It is amazing. And so I just picked a photo. And since I replaced the photo, it applied the styles from the original photo. So it did kind of crop the top of my head out. So we're just going to adjust it, hit crop and shape, and just drag so that my head is in frame. Okay, and we're just gonna drag it off to the side. Putting on a title, I wouldn't put like an entire sentence in the thumbnail. It's just hard to read. So if you could just capture like the essence of your video in like 3 to 5 words, that's pretty good. So now we're gonna change the font to Open Sans. And I like Open Sans just as a default font. It's not like my brand font or anything, but I just like it because it's easy to read. It's sans serif. And when you zoom out on your thumbnail, it's still legible from far away. So we'll do Study With Me. We'll make it a little bigger just by dragging the corner. And then we're going to zhuzh it up a bit and add some effects. So we're going to add an outline to it. Don't worry, it looks a little crazy now, but trust the process. Trust the process. And then we're going to add a drop shadow. Okay, so now we're going to change the text color up here. We're going to make it white. I just default to white text. And since we're putting a black outline, it kind of stands out a bit. You can also change it to a different color. Let's say like you want to add a little bit more of a pop of color on the thumbnail. I would add it to the drop shadow. So we're going to click the eyedropper and we're going to match it to like a pink on like the laptop or something. And then it matches. Sometimes I'll just do like plain white text, no nothing, or plain black text. But if I want something a little bit more special, I will go this route. It's a little bit too muted, so I am going to just adjust that a bit. Let's make it a little bit more vibrant. Icons. Okay, so we have a pencil. Let's do a notebook. I like this. Let's make this white. And we're just gonna randomly just angle these shapes. And then maybe some music. Let's do like headphones or something. Oh my God, these are earbuds. These are tangled earbuds. Oh my goodness. Okay, let's go with these. Oh, I'm not clicking on anything. There you go. And then we'll just rotate them. And then now we're just going to adjust. Let's make the text even bigger. Let's just take up all the space on this thumbnail. Okay, cool. So when we zoom out, okay, that's a little too small. So it looks like this. This thumbnail, we're just gonna start with an image. Again, we're gonna pull in from my Lightroom. So all of these brand photos are all DIY, if you all are wondering. So once we have the photo loaded in and it's all rendered and it's crispy, we're just going to add it to the background. And then since it's taken in portrait, I can only move it up and down. But if I zoom in a little bit, I can move it side to side as well. And then we're just going to add text to it just by hitting the text tab, click add text, And then we're just going to change this to Creative Cloud Express. Just for an example text. And then we're just gonna make it big like this. And of course, Open Sans, extra bold. There you go. And then we're going to add the same effects. We're gonna add a drop shadow, gonna add the outline, and we're gonna change both of these to black this time. Cool. And we're gonna make it big like this. Again, some people just would leave it like without the shadow and without the outline and just be done with that. But again, we want to be a little bit different, stand out from the crowd a little bit. So we're going to add this awesome effects. Okay, we're going to add some doodles because sometimes I'll just leave the photo or the thumbnail like this. Totally fine. But we are Creative Cloud Express and we don't do plain that much anymore. And it's super easy to add like little embellishments like these to your design. And we're just going to add the duotone filter. See, it changed the color to blue. Now we can just make it white. We'll pop this on right here. And let's look for another one. These ones look like little macaronis. I'm into it. Let's click it. Add the duotone filter. Have a great day, y'all. Bye-bye.